Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, and today I'm going to bring to you the first ever quarterly hits and shits. Now, I've said before in previous videos after my best of 2013 that I would actually be doing quarterly rather than monthly favorites, just because I really don't purchase that many products and I would also like to have enough time to really use the product and hopefully give you a better idea of what those products can do for you. So I'm actually bringing you the first quarter 2014 hits and shits, okay? So I'll start off with hair care, and the first thing that I'm loving is the Batiste dry shampoo. Okay, this is for dark dark and deep brown hair. That's what it looks like. And I have been loving this. I've always loved Batiste, but the fact that this actually comes tinted is even better for me, because obviously I don't have blonde hair, and putting white powder on my black hair makes me look like I'm old, essentially. So I've been loving that. What I've been doing is, because I've been experiencing really bad hair fall since moving here to Dubai, I've started to not wash my hair every day, which I used to do, but I actually wash it every 3 days. So I wash it the first day, and then I condition it on the second day, and the third day I use the dry shampoo, and then again I wash, and so on. So this has actually helped me not feel too gritty and sticky and disgusting with my hair. So loving that. The other thing that I've been loving for hair is the Botanics. This is their hair colorant, and this is in the color Sweet Maple Dark Blonde. Now, obviously, I've been using this in my hair, and it hasn't turned my hair blonde. However, you can see from where the light hits it that it's actually a lot lighter than what it used to be really black, and now it's got a shade of brown on it. So I like it. And the one thing that I love about that especially is the conditioner that it comes with. This is the Botanics Color Enriching Conditioner. I don't know if the camera's picking that up. That's what it looks like, and it is a sizable amount of conditioner. Normally you get like one sachet when you buy those other, my camera is not tracking, yeah. When you buy those other products, you normally just get a sachet to condition your hair right after you you wash it off. But this is a 75 ml tube, and it smells really good. It doesn't smell of those ammonia headache-inducing conditioner. So I have been loving this, and this is enriched with grapeseed oil hydrates. Yeah, that one. Okay, whatever it is. Okay, loving that. So those are my hair products. Now I'm going to go to face products or skincare products that I have been loving. First off, I didn't actually include here my cleanser, which is the Origins, what is it called? Origins Checks and Balances. Yeah, it's a frothy face wash. I do like that. However, that I feel really dry and tight when I finish using that. So that's not really my go-to face cleanser. I would still prefer the Cetaphil. So that's why I'm not including that here, because it's not an actual favorite. It's just that I have it, so I'm just going to go ahead and use it. However, there are a few Origin products that I have been loving, and that is the Origins Clear Improvement Active Charcoal Mask to clear your pores. I have been using this since I got it back in December, and you see, I haven't even made much of a dent in it. See just how much I've used. I use it about once a week or every 2 weeks, depending on how I feel about my skin. And to be honest with you, after changing up my skincare, I feel that I have actually improved my skin in such a way that I'm not as oily as I used to be. Speaking of that, the next step that I take is, this is another Origins product, and this is Origins Ginseng Energy Boosting Moisturizer. Okay, that's what it looks like. And this is in 30 ml, sorry, the other product is 50 ml. Okay, now I've been loving this, and you can tell by how much I've used it. I've been alternating this with another moisturizer that I'm going to show right after this one. Okay, so I've been using this up, and I feel really energized when I use this because it smells very citrusy, but also I feel really moisturized. I wouldn't say it's my all-time favorite, but it's definitely in my top five moisturizers. Now, the thing is, I never really thought that I needed moisturizer because I already had oily skin until I read up and realized that I actually do need to moisturize my skin, because then it would make my skin think that I have enough moisture, then it would stop creating all of the oil, which I think is what's causing my skin to actually improve. Okay, the other moisturizer that I alternate that Origins with is the Neutrogena Rapid Wrinkle Repair Moisturizer, and this has got SPF 30 in it, which I love. It's got accelerated retinol, okay, so this has helped my skin drastically. Not only has it reduced my acne, but also the acne scars that I used to have has diminished. Okay, it's barely there. I can now confidently go out of the house without having to put on makeup or any foundation. Like normally, like today, I don't have any foundation on. I just have concealer right here, and the highlight points of my face. But other than that, that's it, right? So I can confidently get out of the house without having to wear any kind of foundation on, except for concealer, and only because my under eyes are really bad. Next, I have also been loving the Origins Ginseng Refreshing Eye Cream to brighten and depuff, and that's how much of it I have used up already. See, I love this because it's got that luminizing effect under the eye, so you don't look as tired. And if I'm not mistaken, this contains some sort of caffeine, so that's what makes it look more awake. So, loving this together with all these products. Another thing that I don't know if this is considered skincare or makeup, but I have come back to my Nivea Lip Butter Vanilla and Macadamia. I love the smell of this product. Okay, hopefully that's been picked. I love the smell of this, and I've used quite a bit of it. I don't know if you can see the dent that I've made on this product. Okay, that's what it looks like. It smells heavenly. I love it. I love it so much. I use this before I go to bed so that when I wake up the next morning, my lips are super supple. Okay. Those are my skincare products. Okay, now I'm going to talk about makeup, and that's what I have in this bag. Now all of the things that I have been loving are in this bag because this is what I have been taking with me to work. Okay, now let's get on with the show. I have some makeup brushes essentials. Makeup brush essentials, there you go, here we are. Okay, so these are the brushes that I have been using non-stop. This is the Sigma Blending E 25, which I use for eyeshadow. Okay, I use the Real Techniques Deluxe Crease Brush, which I use for my concealer, for applying the concealer that I have on my face at the moment. Low focus. Okay, I also have the Tarte Dual Ended Brush. Okay, and this I use for my eyebrows. I have the Sigma Face Tapered F25, which I use for my setting powder. I use it under the eyes after I do my concealer. I use it on all over the face, essentially. This is what I use for setting powder. I have the Coastal Scents BRCN25, which I use for blush. And the last thing is the Real Techniques Contour Brush, which I use for contouring. That's what it's for, right? Now, what products do I use in conjunction with those brushes? Those brushes live in my makeup bag. They are literally in my purse all the time. I don't believe I've used or picked up any other brush, especially after I've stopped using foundation and essentially just use concealer. I don't really bring a concealer brush. Okay, the powders, okay, the products that I use with that. First thing that I put on my face is the Chorus Concealer Corrector, and this is in medium. Let me just open that up for you. That's what I've been using. I use that triangular shape under the eyes, on in between my brows, down the bridge of my nose, on my cupid's bow, and on my chin to highlight those areas of my face. So that's it. Okay, and then I powder up with the Hourglass Ambient Lighting Powder, and this is in the color Dim Light. Okay, let's not blind you. That goes all over my face, but particularly under the eye to help set the concealer that I use. I then follow it up with, where's that little thing? Oh, my eyebrow product, which is a Tarte Emphasize Brow Mousse in Rich Brown. Okay, that's what it looks like. That's what I use on my eyebrows. That's what I have on my eyebrows right now. I have also been loving this has been with me for a long time. This is my Benefit Hoola Deluxe Sample. Okay, and that's what it looks like. It's a perfect contour product for my skin tone. I love it. I use it on the sides of my nose, on my cheekbones, on the sides of my forehead, and even on the sides of my eyes to create this kind of depth. Okay, and what I've been loving for blush in the last 2 months, I would say, is the Tarte Amazonian Clay 12-Hour Blush in Imagined. Okay, this is also a deluxe sample. This came in their Christmas set, the one with the three blushes and a brush. Okay, and this is in Imagined. I love the bright pink because it brightens up your face, essentially. That's what it does for me, at least. Okay. I sometimes pair that with the Josie Maran Color Stick and Spice. That's what it looks like. Okay, and that is the color. It actually reminds me of the Stila. The Stila convertible color. It doesn't want to focus in Peony. Okay, so those are some of the face products that I have been loving. I have also been loving my Hypnose Drama Mascara by Lancome. Just simple mascara with the S-Curve Wand. I don't know if you can see that. That's what it looks like. This is a deluxe sample that I got from my Lash Stash from Sephora more than a year ago. I have also been loving several eye pencils. Today I'm wearing the green Skinny Smolder Eyes by Tarte. Okay, if I want to intensify the look of my eyes, I wear the black one. It's called Onyx. The green one is called Azurite Green. I also have sort of a bronze, which is called it's called Purple Garnet, but I don't understand why it's called purple when there's no purple in it. So those are the three that I've been loving. And I also have the Makeup Forever Professionals Aqua Shadow in 28E and 2E. So let me go ahead and swatch these for you. Okay, this is azure green, purple, what? What is it? Azurite green, that's right. Let's smudge that. Then I have the black one. They are so freaking creamy. Like you don't need to put a lot of pressure. I'm just gonna go ahead and swatch them all at once. Okay. The aqua shadow. Don't fall. Okay. There you go. Okay. Let's see. These three are the Tarte Skinny Smolder Eyes. That's Purple Garnet, okay, Onyx Azurite Green, and then here are the Makeup Forever ones, which is 28E, this champagne-y color here, and the other one is 2E. Now, the Makeup Forever one I use under my my waterline. I use it on my waterline to wake up the eyes. And then the rest of the skinny smolder eyes I use on the top lid, on the lash line, to create a bit of dimension. And the Aqua Shadow 2E, which is the dark brown over here, I actually use that on my crease and blend it with my fingers to create some definition over there. Loving that! For eyeliner, I use the Physicians Formula Eye Booster, and this is in black, ultra black, it says. That's what I use. I think I'm running out of it because it's getting a bit liquidy at the moment. So I don't know what gives. What else is there? Ooh. I have also been loving the Josie Maran Argan Illuminator. Okay. I usually either mix this with my foundation. If I am wearing foundation, I just put it on my face as is. Okay. For lips, I don't really have much. I don't really have anything in particular. I'm not really a lip person. I do have a lot of lipsticks, but somehow I'm not a lip person. I almost forgot. One more eye product, or one more makeup product that I've been loving is the Lorac Pro Palette in Pewter Eyeshadow. And it's a single one. That's what it looks like. And this is beautiful on the lids. Like, I just use this with the E25 blending brush by Sigma. And I put it all over my lids and I get dimension. Okay, that's pretty much it for my hits. Now, for the shits. I don't really have a lot of shits, but I do have shits. In terms of skincare, this one, Botanics Hot Cloth Cleanser. Okay, that's what it looks like. This is from Boots. See that? Okay, I don't like it. It's greasy, of course, because it's a cleansing balm. But not only is it greasy, it's so hard to remove even with, not warm water, but hot water. Even with that, with soaking the cloth into the hot water, it's difficult. I have to follow it up with my face brush, otherwise it's going to stick on my skin. And if I don't clean properly, I break out. I break out with this. This makes me break out. And it smells weird. The other thing that is a shit for me is the Bourjois 123 Perfect CC Cream. Now, this product is not good for oily skin. And that's all I have to say. It's not good for oily skin because within 2 hours of putting this on, I've got like pools of oil on my nose and in my pores. In 4 hours, it was off my face. It didn't even last 4 hours. And this is in the color 33 Rose Beige, which is too pink. The color itself is fine, but the undertone is too pink for me. So it just looks awful. I look gray. And then the last thing is the Sephora Outrageous Prisma Chrome. And this is in Outrageous Metallic Peach. It's beautiful by its, looking at that. Look at how that quilted. I've heard a lot of great things about the other color, so I wanted to try this because taupe doesn't really work well for me, but this one in peach looked really lovely. But it's so freaking flaky. Like, you almost look like you're putting glitter on your face with this product. It's not, and it doesn't blend very well. Also, what's happened to me is that I don't know if it's, if there's an overlay on here. That's why it's pretty chalky and pretty flaky and it kicks up a lot of powder. But it's really pretty when you swatch it. That's what it looks like swatched. It's pretty when you swatch it, but it really doesn't apply smoothly. And I don't know if I just have to go deeper and use up the top part for it to come out properly, but this just doesn't work for me. Let me know how you use this kind of product because I have never had this much difficulty with an eyeshadow before. Alright, I think I've taken too much time. This is almost a 20-minute video, so I'll see you again in my next quarterly hits and shits. Bye! Bye.